Hello everyone, welcome back and thanks for joining me in this video. In my previous video, we discussed about encrypting files and directories individually using gpz command. I will link that video on the top for your reference. And this time we're going to discuss about encrypting the whole file system. There are a few different reasons that you might want to encrypt a file system. One could be you want to protect sensitive information while the system is at rest state. Another reason could be you do not want to individually encrypt files and directories stored inside the file system. But the file system encryption comes with its own drawbacks, which we discussed briefly in my last video, and I just linked that video on the top. Some of the drawbacks are it uses more resources and the slower performance, difficult data recovery process, etc. But if encrypting the file system is your need, Linux provides tools to do so. You can encrypt the file system during the installation if your installation steps provide an option to encrypt the file system. And if not, you can always manually encrypt the file system. And in this video, we're going to see the manual part since there is not much you have to do to perform the encryption during installation except just selecting that option using a checkbox, and installation process takes care of the rest. And in this video, we're going to use encrypt setup utility to create an encrypted partition. If the utility is not installed in your system, you could use dm-install encrypt setup. It's already installed in my system. And if you're using Ubuntu, you can use apt-get install encrypt setup. And for Fedora, you can use dnf install encrypt setup. And the encrypt setup that I have is version 2.3.3. And the distribution I'm using is Red Hat Enterprise Linux 8. Okay, with that, let's go and start today's video. So I have added a partition of 500 megabyte for this purpose. We can do lsblk. And this is the disk that I added, 500 megabyte. I talked about this lsblk command and other 9 commands which deal with the partition table. And I'll link the video on the top right corner if you're interested to check it out later. So now let's create a partition in the disk using fdisk command. Create a new partition, primary. I'm going to select everything default. Okay, p. So it created a new partition, /dev/sdv1. And I'm going to write it. So lsblk, now we'll notify the operating system about the partition table change. So partprov /dev/sdv. So this command will just notify the operating system about the updated partition table. Okay, the partition is ready. Now the next step is to partition it for the LUKS. So LUKS stand for Linux Unified Key Setup. And LUKS is a disk encryption specification created for Linux and uses a device mapper crypt, also known as dm-crypt. And dm-crypt is a transparent disk encryption subsystem in Linux version 2.6 and later. So let's use that. Crypt setup is our command. LUKS format /dev/sdv1. So we're going to format using LUKS for the partition that we just created. It's giving us a warning that the data will be overwritten and our issuer want to proceed. So we have to type yes in capital letters. So if you're converting existing partition into encrypted partition, just make sure that you back up your data, because once you format using LUKS, it'll delete everything and you'll create a fresh partition. So this is the passphrase to be used to encrypt the partition. So we are going to use, let's do linux encrypt. So now it converted the partition into LUKS partition, and you can see the header information using encrypt setup. LUKS dump /dev/sdv1. Do more if you want to see more information. Let's clear the screen. Now we need to open or initialize the encrypted partition and give it a name. We'll do crypt setup. LUKS open is the option /dev/sdv1. Let's give a name, encrypted, for example. So this is the passphrase that we entered, Linux encrypt. So LUKS creates a new block device encrypted over existing block device, and we just open it and you can see it inside /dev/mapper, where we can see our existing logical volumes as well. And if we do crypt setup -v status encrypted, which is the name of the encrypted partition, and encrypted, it's active, type LUKS2 and key size, key location, and all the information as well. Now, after this step, you can create a mount point and mount this encrypted partition, but you can also create a logical volume out of it. So let's do that. vz-create, let's give a name, encrypted volume group. And the device is encrypted So the volume group is created. You can use VG display command to display all the volume groups in your system. So this is the volume group we created. Now next step is create a logical volume inside the volume group. And this blk, so 483 encrypted partition. So let's create lv create to create a logical volume. The name of logical volume is encrypted. Let's do logical volume. L size, let's give 200 MB, and the volume group name is encrypted volume group. So volume group is created. Now if we do lsblk, it should give us as a logical volume 200 MB and the name of the partition. And we can use lv display to display logical volume information. Now it's time to designate a file system type to the volume. So if we do lsblk hyphen f, it shows the file system type. So our logical volume does not have any file system type, and we're going to assign it now. Since Red Hat Enterprise Linux 8 uses XFS as a default file system, and I have other partitions formatted into XFS format as well, let's format this new partition using the same file system. So for that, we're going to use mkfs command, make file system.xfs. We'll format the partition into XFS file system. And the name of the partition or the volume is encrypted LV, which is a logical volume inside encrypted VG volume group. So now lsblk hyphen f, now it is formatted with XFS file system. If you did not want to create a volume group or a logical volume inside volume group, you could skip those steps and directly come here, which is create a mount point and start mounting the device. So let's create a mount point directory. Let's do encrypted fs, encrypted file system. And we are going to mount our logical volume inside encrypted fs. And we could type mount to see the mounted partition, and you could see at the bottom, or you could do mount grip encrypted. So our encrypted logical volume is mounted inside encrypted fs folder, and the file system type is xfs and other attributes. Now our encrypted partition is ready to use. So if you go to mnt encrypted fs, so nothing is there. Let's create a directory, mkdir encrypted directory. Let's create a file inside the directory called test file. This is an encrypted file system, control D. So we manually mounted the encrypted partition to encrypted fs directory, and this is not persistent. And if we want to mount the encrypted partition during the boot process, then we have to do a couple of things. First, we need to make an entry in etc cryptab file to open and initialize the encrypted partition during the boot process. So let's go and do that. Let's see if there's anything there. Nothing. So the entry we're going to make is, let's use the cat command. And the format of this file is name of the LUKS device, which is encrypted in our case, space, physical partition, which is /dev/sdb1, space. And the third entry is the location of the file where we would be saving our passphrase to decrypt the file system during the boot process. You don't have to save a passphrase into the file and give the location. You can simply save like this. But what happens is during the boot process, your system will ask for the passphrase to decrypt the file system so that the file system could be mounted. If you're remotely managing the device, probably it is a good idea to store this password here so that you would not need to be present to boot the system. Enter control D. You might think that the password is there in a plain text format and does not provide any security against encryption. So let me repeat it again. The file system encryption protects your data only when the system is at rest and not after the system is booted up. It is designed to protect the file system when the system is off. So if someone gets hold of the file system, they could not open it or decrypt it. So now let's create that plain text file where we would be saving our passphrase, which is Linux encrypt, control D. Now we need to add this key to the device, encrypt setup. LUKS add key /date/sdb1/root/. So now we are associating a passphrase to the device. It will verify the passphrase. Okay, so the passphrase is added to the device. And the final step is to add an entry in etcfs tab to mount the file system during the boot process. So by making an entry on cryptf file, this entry, it will tell the system to initialize the encrypted partition during the boot process. And we supply our passphrase to verify the encryption. And the next step is to auto mount the partition during the boot process. And for that, we need to make an entry to this file. Let's go and add a line here, /dev/encrypted volume group encrypted logical volume tab mount point is encrypted fs which we created tab file system is xfs tab defaults tab 0.0. Save it. Now the setup is done and we can reboot the system and verify if the file we created is there. So let's reboot. Okay, the system is up. Now we can type mount again and it's to mount grip encrypted. So our encrypted partition is mounted and we could do our mount point and directory is there and our file is also there. And do lsblk one more time. So our encrypted file system is here, file system type and the mount point. Now we have created an encrypted partition. We can create a user's home directory in this partition if you'd like, or store any sensitive information into this partition. And later, for some reason, if you need to change the passphrase for the encryption, you can use encrypt setup looks add key /dev/stb1. Now we're going to add a different key. So it is asking us to enter the existing passphrase, which is Linux encrypt, and we'll ask for the new passphrase. So let's do Linux 123098. Linux 123098. And now we can delete the old passphrase. To do that, looks remove key /dev/stb1. Now supply the passphrase you want to delete, which is Linux encrypt, our old passphrase, and that is gone. So our new passphrase is Linux 123098, which you have to update inside this file. Let's delete this one and add Linux 123098. Let's also see what happens if we delete this entry from here. So let's delete this one. Shift D, save the file, let's reboot. Okay, now it is asking us the passphrase for the encrypted disk. So what we did is we updated our password and we attached a new password to the device, encrypted device. And we also updated our password in plain text file, which is stored inside root folder, but we deleted the location of the file inside etc/cryptdev file. So it could not find the passphrase. Now it is asking us to enter that passphrase for the encrypted disk. And here we have to supply our new passphrase because we deleted our old passphrase and attached the new passphrase to the encrypted partition. And Linux 123098, enter. So now the system is back and we're logged in. We could do lsblk one more time. So partition is there and we could do mount. It is also mounted. And our file is there. So everything looks good. And our cryptdev file does not have the location of the passphrase, but we can add it now. We just saw what happens if you do not give that location. So shift $ root inpass.txt. And obviously that file has new password. So this is it. That's how you encrypt your file system. If you do not want to individually encrypt your files and directories using gpg command, which we discussed in our last video. So I hope this video was helpful to you, and I'll continue creating such videos in the future as well. So please be sure to come back and check those future videos. Thanks for being with me on this video, and I'll see you next week. Until then, take care, keep exploring, and keep learning Linux.